You know, I've worked in for companies that were nonprofit, not by choice, which is a different animal. But you're right in saying that the job I have now at Minnesota Public Radio is a nonprofit. It's a mission-driven organization, and we have a long history here of in the state, in particular, of serving the public in a mission-driven way. At the same time, I think about. You know, when I've talked to people on the staff, I say, you know, in New York City, some hospitals are nonprofit and some hospitals are for-profit. And do you really think you're going to give a break to the nonprofit hospital when you go in there and you're not feeling well because they're a nonprofit? No, you're probably going to expect the best possible care you can get. And so we're in certainly in the news media side, in the music side, this is less so the case, but in the news media side, I don't think our audiences are like, hey, they really were pretty bad today, but that's okay because they're a nonprofit. Right. I think their expectations are quite high, mm-hmm. that we will deliver the very best product that they could imagine. And I think the challenge that you're alluding to a little bit, Arm, is that our industry is changing. And we're not just running a radio business anymore. We're running a radio business, an on-demand business, a digital business. And we're running basically three businesses at the same time on the business model that supports one business. And that forces hard decisions and tough choices. And those who live in Minnesota know that we've had to make some tough choices at Minnesota Public Radio. But it's the idea that 5 years from now, we want to be even more successful than we are today. And if we don't do anything, I think the one truism of the changing media world of the last 20 years, that if you don't do anything differently, you can gladly expect to be out of business in not too long a period of time. So those are some of, thanks for that really easy question. I really appreciate that.
I mean, maybe because I'm familiar with the museum world, but nonprofits still do have to answer to
a board.
You know, yeah, a board, but also if you get a major grant, you know, there's accountability. It's not, I mean, maybe it's different in Minnesota.
Well, no, I think
maybe that's where I'll be in 5 years.
I think one of the differences is you know, we rely on membership support, which is 130,000 people who are not Goldman Sachs.
Right.
And
it's
so
it's a very different model.
We're accountable to the community in that respect. Right. We also have a board, and we're accountable to them and major donors. But, it's a little more complicated.